Welcome learners, you are watching Eclectic English with Roma and this is lecture 2 of chapter 3 of your book Flamingo, and the name of the chapter is Deep Water and it's written by William Douglas. I have already posted one video on this chapter wherein I shared with you all the various reasons of fears. I talked about the author, introduction of the chapter, the summary of the chapter with the help of the story map, right? So do watch the previous video for your better understanding. I'll share the link of that video in the description box, right? Okay, so this lecture is on the analysis part of this chapter. Okay, so here I'll talk about the title justification, message, values raised in this chapter and the various themes in the chapter. Okay, so if you will like this video, do subscribe my channel for further updates and don't forget to press the like button, right? So let's get started. First, we will talk about the title justification. Now we need to understand if this title Deep Water is justified or not. It can be asked in your board exams that critically analyze the title Deep Water written by William Douglas. So what all points you will write, that I'll share with you, right? So the title is highly apt, that is appropriate and quite suggestive. It is quite relatable to all the incidents which happened in the story. The story revolves around the fear, right? And that fear centers around deep water and drowning. Okay, while reading the title, it at once focuses on the main theme, that is experiencing fear of death underwater. You can recall the two incidents wherein author developed aversion to water. Very well remember California beach incident when he was 3 or 4 years old and he was drowned. And next was YMCA pool incident again, wherein he was deliberately plunged into water by an 18 years old boy and he became hydrophobic. Right. But yes, once the author became determined enough to overcome his fears, so he could go and dive and swim again in the deep waters, right? So the whole story shows that the title is apt and correct and justified, right? Okay, now we will talk about the message. Now, message is that what is the learning through this chapter? What is our major take back through this chapter? Okay, so the major learning is that we all shall say no to fear. Okay, so moreover, we learned that it is not death, but the fear of death that creates terror in our mind. So fear needs to be shaken off like dust of snow. Okay, moreover, determination and courage helps overcome all the fears in our lives. So we all need to exhibit these two qualities, right? That is courage and determination. Now we will talk about the various values raised in this chapter. Now, what are the various values? Actually, these all values were brilliantly exhibited by William Douglas. And so while writing the character sketch of the author, you can write these value points. You can elaborate on these value points, right? Okay, so the first value which we learned through this chapter is determination. Now, what is determination? It is firmness and resolution. So author exhibited determination. He became determined enough to overcome his fears, right? Next is optimism. Optimism means hopefulness. So in case the writer had not been hopeful, had not been optimistic enough to overcome his fears, he would never have dared to attempt learning swimming again in his life, even after having two bad incidents in his life, right? Next is perseverance. So what is perseverance? Perseverance is persistence in doing something despite difficulty or delay in achieving success. In other words, it is also called as tenacity. So author exhibited this quality beautifully. Next is diligence. Okay, so diligence is thoroughness and attentiveness. That is again reflected in the character of the narrator, because he was attentive and throughout the time when his instructor taught him how to perfect himself in the art of swimming. Okay, next is openness to challenges. Yes, so we all need to be open to the new opportunities, as the author was open to the new opportunities. Even after he was given the clean sheet by his instructor, he didn't restrain himself to the pool, right? He wanted to test his skills in treacherous and unfamiliar waters till his phobia vanquished completely, right? Next is courage. Courage is again bravery. The author exhibited this quality again at various incidents wherein he faced, wherein he had near death like experience. Okay. And last one is endurance. Now, endurance is tolerance or patience. So the author had been quite tolerant while learning swimming and while overcoming his fears, right? And at last he was able to vanquish all his fears. Okay, now the next is the theme of the chapter. Okay, so the theme, now the theme, that this whole chapter focuses on the theme of childhood fears, right? So the childhood fears must never be treated lightly, right? It's a serious concern. All the parents must help their children to overcome their fears, right? Because once these fears remain in the mind, it just do not let go off so easily, right? Why? Because past memories leave an indelible mark on the mind of the children. So parents must help their children. Okay, so we all need to analyze our fears, right? So the whole story focuses on the fact that childhood fears must never be treated lightly, and if they are not tackled properly, then they make deep inroads in one's psychology, right? So in the end, Douglas analyzed his fear and finally he overcame all his fears, right? So that's it for today's lecture. In case you have any query, please feel free, you can post your queries in the comment box, or you can mail on romag9323@gmail.com. Thank you so much. Please like this video and subscribe my channel. Thank you.